And now let's get a round of applause for the host of the Skylight Books Podcast.
Hello, friends. Before we begin, Justin would like to make a statement.
I'm going to read some Virginia Woolf for some reason. Orlando had become a woman. There is no denying it. But in every other respect, Orlando remained precisely as he had been. The change of sex, though it altered their future, did nothing whatever to alter their identity. Their faces remained, as their portraits prove, practically the same. His memory, but in future we must, for convention's sake, say her for his and she for he. Her memory, then, went back through all the events of her past life without encountering any obstacle. Many people taking this into account and holding that such a change of sex is against nature have been at great pains to prove, one, that Orlando had always been a woman, two, that Orlando is at this moment a man. Let biologists and psychologists determine. So I'd like to ask Virginia Woolf, too woke? Not woke enough. Let's discuss. Just kidding. Hello. Okay. My name is Justin Remer.
I'm Allan Traylor.
I'm Tyler Austin. And we are here today to talk about a once considered unadaptable piece of IP that takes on gender norms, the patriarchy, fluidity. We're seeing Barbie. I'm sorry, we're calling an audible. And it's Greta, come out. Oh, she's not here, I'm sorry.
They ship the 35 millimeter print though.
Okay, we'll watch Orlando.
I think we should ask the audience.
Has everyone seen Orlando already?
Who has never seen this movie?
Yeah.
All right.
Delicious treat.
This is great. So normally, we host the monthly Better Than the Movie series on the Skylight Books podcast. Skylight Books, you might have noticed, is a bookstore two doors down. We do have copies of Orlando for sale over there.
And if you buy a special copy today, I will, in favor of this movie, write a personal bad poetry in the receipt for you. Or if you're nasty, I'll write it on the book.
And if you really like us today, we'll just switch our podcast to One Land Go, where we break down Orlando one frame at a time for 3-hour episodes. So just...
I'm pumped.
That's out. It's a backdoor pilot.
Actually, that's not a bad idea. There's so many sumptuous frames in this movie. It looks so good.
Oh, this
Tilda looks
beautiful.
So good. This movie could also just be called Tilda Swinton's Face, because there's so much face and it's such good face.
The best face.
Buster Keaton's got nothing on this face. This is a very good face. We should talk a little bit about the background, both of the book. So normally, with Better Than the Movie, we determine, is the book better, is the movie better? With this, there's such different animals that, like, we're not going to worry about that. Like, we're really excited to see the movie today. You should also check out the book. It's a very different experience. I think I should talk a little bit about Sally Potter, but maybe you talk a little bit about the book first. It came first.
It came first, 1928, October. It's an immediate hit, critically and commercially. It's based on a woman, a lover of Virginia Woolf's, who she had for many, many years. You might know her as Lady Nicholson or Vita Sackville West. Sackville West? Oh, boy. Sackville, thank you.
Appreciate it.
That's what these guys do on the podcast. And basically, the fact that everybody knew was about her sort of drew interest in the book and made it a huge bestseller. Also, there are parts of the book that, like, Vita really never understood in her lifetime. Like, there's this whole running bit of metaphor about a gray goose that she's chasing in the book, that the character of Orlando's chasing in the book. And that was about Vita never being a very good writer. And always chasing a successful novel. And at one time, Virginia Woolf said to her husband, "Vita writes with a brass pen," which is a sick burn. That's pretty much all I get.
Nice. Also, a funny thing in the book, there are portraits and then photographs of Orlando throughout their life, and the last two pictures are just pictures of Vita Sackville West.
Yeah.
which is kind of like a joke for like, haha, I get it.
And I will say, and Vita had one other quote about she wrote a letter to Virginia being like, you have invented a new form of narcissism because I love Orlando, which is awesome. That's really cool. She knew that about herself. That's great.
Nice. Related question. So has anybody here seen a movie directed by Sally Potter that is not Orlando?
Oh, no way.
Nice. Which one? Yes, which is the title of a movie, but also just sounds like you're like, yes, I have. Yes is a very interesting one, because that one, I think in 2004, stars Joan Allen and Simon Akbarian, and it's a love story told mostly in iambic pentameter. Some reason people didn't go to that one so much. A really great film in the 90s, The Tango Lesson, in which Sally Potter stars basically as herself. It's kind of like the pale European ladies version of How Stella Got Her Groove Back. I do recommend it, even though I think Rotten Tomatoes gives it like a 55%.
What do they know?
We don't listen to that.
Yeah, heck with Rotten Tomatoes. And The Man Who Cried, which is a movie I saw.
Tell us about it.
Anyhow.
Do you remember anything?
I know Christina Ricci's in it. That's the reason I saw it.
Yeah. Pretty good.
Christina Ricci is the star. I watched the trailer. I was like, I do not remember a frame of this film. But that might not be Sally Potter's fault. It might just be film nerd overload fault. Allan, your thoughts on this film. We watched this film. You love this film.
This film is absolutely beautiful and outrageously funny, honestly. I was not really prepared for how funny this movie is. Like all her little Zach Morris like timeout moments throughout this movie, wonderful. That's really all I can say. It's a beautiful movie, and I can't wait for everyone to laugh along with it. It's great.
Nice. I think that's a perfect note to end on. See this picture. Oh, wait, you're here. So, yes, enjoy this picture.
Enjoy.
Bye.
Thank you.